we're seeing on the left. What's your advice to them?
Well, clearly there is an identity crisis within the Democratic Party, and we're seeing, we saw that clearly in this race we're talking about. The heir apparent to Nancy Pelosi is beaten by someone who has certainly much more progressive views. But the key here and the takeaway is that the Democratic Party is moving towards a direction of a new generation, a new gender, a new race, and that is the wave of the future with regard to how they will, in my view, succeed. Look, they need to do exactly what Cortez said. She knocked on doors that had been ignored. She had a clearly defined message, and she didn't take anything for granted. Crowley missed a debate, phoned it in, and took it for granted. She didn't do that. She made sure that every stone was turned over and every hand that she could shake was shaked, and that is clearly important. But it's also important to have a good message, have the right candidate, and make sure, in my view, these red-blooded reforms are the key, the red hand resistance of attacking Trump voters and harassing them is not the way to go. We need to, the Democrats need to give their voters something to vote for and not just anti-Trump. It's something to vote for.
Well, Angela, on the flip side of that, the president also isn't letting up on his attacks of Maxine Waters. I mean, he put out another tweet this morning saying, congratulations to Maxine Waters, whose crazy rants have made her, together with Nancy Pelosi, the unhinged face of the Democrat Party. Together, they're going to make make America weak again. Do his attacks hurt Democrats in any way, or do you say thank you, Mr. President? That's a get out the vote operation.
I don't think it helps or hurts. I think the people who typically vote progressive or Democratic are going to continue to do that regardless of what Donald Trump tweets with all of his typos. Like, that just, it has no real lasting effect. I think the reality of it is, what does hurt is the more that people continue to lie or misrepresent what Congresswoman Waters said. She did not threaten harassment. She did not threaten harm, but Donald Trump did. What does not help him and what will help her is when he says, watch out, Max. Those threats, those veiled threats, his clear demonstrations that he's threatened by women, by people who will hold him accountable, and especially black women. He's had a run with black women on Twitter. That is not going to help his cause. It certainly will continue to help ours. But again, I think, and Alice, on your last point about knocking on doors, Congresswoman Waters in her district and supporting members all over the country has always never taken the little guy and the little gal for granted. She's always made sure that every voice is heard. She represents the people's power, and I think that the Democratic Party has a lot to learn from that as well.
And Kate, let me just say, I want to, for the facts matter here, Congressman Waters did encourage people to go out and confront Trump, people of the administration.
Confront is different than harass.
But what's happening is there is a tone and civility in this country that has taken everything to the extreme. And I'm not excusing
Donald
the president.
Trump.
I'm not excusing him. He's just as guilty as she is.
Alice, it's not okay to create a false equivalency between Donald Trump's messaging and Congresswoman Maxine Waters' messaging. She is right to call for the impeachment of a president who is dishonest, who's morally corrupt, who lacks compassion, who doesn't treat the people of this world as global citizens as they deserve to be treated. Their tones are completely different. I resent the misrepresentation and the mischaracterization of everything she's ever said, everything she's ever worked for. Look at her record compared to his. You'll see light years of difference. It's just not fair, and it's not honest.
Okay. Encouraging confrontation and harassment, regardless of the tone.
She did not encourage harassment. She encouraged confrontation and agitation strategy.
It's not acceptable, and it's dangerous.
It's not actually dangerous. What's dangerous is Donald calling for a violent attack on her because she wants his cabinet to be held accountable for what they're doing. To be holding someone accountable is completely different than harassment. Again, I resent the mischaracterization and misrepresentation of her remarks.
I think one thing we know for sure is we've reached a point where I don't think this administration or this White House is qualified to talk about calling for civility anymore when it
comes to where the
president began with his campaign and where things stand now. Regardless.
Sure.
It's great to see all of you on this fine day, though. Mark, Alice, Angela, thanks.